friends, today in this video we are going to talk about how to deal with a hyperactive child. So, especially considering the current scenario in the world, that is the situation of COVID-19, where we cannot take our kids outside to play. We have to ensure that they stay at home and they are safe, right? So, keeping that thing in mind, but before those things, let us understand what is hyperactive. So, hyperactive is basically a term which is used for the child who is extremely active and is not able to control their motor activity or the mental activity. You will always see them roaming here and there, right? And they cannot sit still for a longer duration. So, they always keep on roaming here around, right? So, this is not a situation we need to understand. This is not a situation which is a problematic situation until and unless a child is actually able to control his behavior with a little guidance and training. So before that, you know, we need to ensure that we give them the right training so that they move on the right path, right? So let us understand now what a child behavior is all about. We interact with kids day in, day out, right, as a parent. So that's our duty to ensure that we do right things in front of them, because today's kids are very clever, they are very smart, and they are very proactive, you know. So more than what we think about them. So you will not even come to know what they have learned from you or from the world around with whomsoever they are interacting day in, day out. So if you want your kid to behave differently, then it is your duty to ensure that you behave differently in front of them. Because you will not even come to know the way you are dealing, the way you are interacting with people. They are learning everything from you. So the learning starts from home itself. It is your duty to ensure that you do right things in front of them. So when you are, don't even think while dealing with them that they are the bonded labor. No, they are not. So don't expect that once you ask them to sit, they'll sit down. No, they might will do exactly opposite to what you are saying. So that's how you need to understand that while dealing with a child, it is you who need to become a child first. You need to bring yourself at their pace so that they become friendly with you and they start understanding what you wanted to do and how, you know, what exactly you want expect from them. So they'll understand it eventually, but you need to be a kid with them first, right? You have to bring child inside you outside, absolutely in front of them. So there are simple activities by doing which you can actually make them calm, controlled, because a hyperactive child usually is very, as I said, he's overactive. He cannot stand still for even a few minutes, and you will see this is very common between the toddlers, I'll say, or the child between the age of 3 to 6 years. So that's your duty to see that how, what activities you can do to ensure that their mind will become stable eventually and they get the habit of sitting still sitting quietly at one place for a longer duration. So there are simple activities what you can do. Like if you remember, probably when we were a child, right, we used to play few games with our siblings or maybe with our parents also. Simple activities like balancing a book on your head, like this. Maybe you can just place a book on your head and you can just start walking around and ask your child to do the same along with you, right? So once you start doing all these things, he will actually start loving these, because you need to understand what are the games that he loves to play with you. So it is you as a parent, your duty to understand where actually your child will enjoy. At the same time, he should learn to focus. So as I said, a simple activity of balancing a book on your head, start walking, and just tell them with a simple rule, once it's fell down, you have to start from the beginning again, okay? So this activity will actually make him focus on the book. So once he starts keeping the book on his head, And once he starts like walking straight, so he will understand that he has to keep his focus here. The moment he loses focus, the book will fall, right? So you need to ensure that he should do this thing. And or maybe the other games around, maybe you can play the same lemon race what we used to do in our school times, you know, keeping a lemon on a spoon and then just walk straight along with it. It's like a race, lemon race. So it will also keep his focus on that particular spoon so that he will ensure that that spoon doesn't fall. Okay. And similarly, if I'll just share a few more games with you, you know, you can ask your child to stand on one leg and then just keep his focus on the sound, close his eyes and just listen to what sounds are going around. So by this way, you can make different sounds. Maybe you can sound like this. Just ask him to, you know, what sound it is. Maybe you can, or you can just ask your child to hear what all things he's listening. So maybe you can tap on a table, or maybe you can move a chair, you can ring some bell, or just ask him to listen the chirping of the birds around. So that's how he will learn how to meditate. He will learn how to sit stable. So this is not going to happen overnight, as I said. This will happen eventually. So you have to ensure that these activities you have to keep on doing on daily basis. So I'll not say that keep playing same games daily. You can change the games every single day. For a week, maybe you can keep a routine, and eventually it is not only you only who can play. You can ask your family members also to play these games with your child. So once you spend some time with your child, this is not only going to make him more stable, more settled, but it will also create a bond between you and your child. That's how we need to we have also built our relationship with our parents, right? So today in this video, whatever I am sharing with you, this is purely based on my own observations, my own personal learnings and experience as a parent. So would like to share with you, and would love to see videos from all of you, all my viewers, probably playing with your kid the same games what I just shared. And I will be adding probably in my next video your videos, which will actually motivate me also to share more thoughts with you, and let's see how far we can take it ahead together. Thank you.